that. Let me check. Okay, that day. The screw didn't go through none of the capacitors that space out to the touching. Let me see if I see smoke. Okay, it seems I've got it. So let me solder this. Okay, I'll stop the video just to tidy up on the wires and I'll come right back. I've finished tidying up the wires. Presently, I'm using my pistol grip to do the last part of the video. This is what the power supply looks like. That's the best way I could get the wires tidied up. The video itself went a bit too long. I have it in two parts. This is the fuse for the 12 amp regulator. This is the fuse for this power supply and this power supply. I did some modifications to the system, which I'll be talking about in another video. This is what the wiring is like after I've done everything. This is the front of the power supply. While I was in it, I spoke about this rocker switch. When I put it up, it wasn't functional. I've repaired that and placed another rocker switch into it. This is it, what it looks like. Let me plug in. This is the 12 volt side. When it's dead, it's off. The 12 volt is off. This is the 19 volt side. We have 19 volts here. These two here is straight 19. This side is the amp regulator. When I increase the voltage, you could see the light here. It comes on. The voltmeter doesn't flicker like that with the naked eye, but as using the camera, it flickers. And this side is standby 5 volts. If you find this video is helpful, please like, comment, subscribe,
and click on the bell icon to be notified of further videos. Everything I use in the video, I'll have it in the, I will have a link in the description below. With all that said, until the next one, don't forget to click the bell icon. Until the next one, goodbye. Better let go. You decide if you're ever gonna